Are you ready? Are you ready? This is an open house. A house for sharing all that we've got. A house for seekers and stumblers and the lot. For elders and middlers and beloved teens. For children and babies and all in between. For saints and sinners, the well-seasoned and beginners. All of us equal, none below or above. Gathered by God in this open house full of love. Want to hear it again? I took the hours. Here we go. This is an open house. A house for sharing all that we've got. A house for seekers and stumblers and the lot. For elders and middlers and our beloved teens. For children and babies and all in between. For saints and sinners, the well-seasoned and beginners. All of us equal, none below or above. Gathered by God in a house full of love. Welcome. Let us... You hear that high-pitched sound that just happened? Do you know what that is? You know how they tell you to turn off your phones and your Wi-Fi on airplanes? Somebody flew over and they were trying to use their Wi-Fi. That's what that was. That's what I'm saying anyway. That's my story. Yeah, I'm sticking to the subject. I just wanted to talk to you for a second about Abram and all his descendants. Made me think about the gathered community here. And I'm just so happy to see so many names on the wall. And if you didn't get to do that, you can add to them later. You know, Abram had many descendants, and those descendants became eventually the nation of Israel, the Hebrew people. They went through many trials and tribulations, and God formed them as a community in the desert for 40 years. And then over the years, with the many kings and prophets, they formed and formed and formed into a people of faith. And that's just like us. We've been formed into a people of faith. But more than Abram and all his descendants, I've been thinking about sunflowers for the last few weeks. You know, I love sunflowers, and this is the most sunflowers we've ever had in church. I'm very excited about it. But I learned something a few weeks ago that, in fact, I don't know how many of you knew this, but all of these things in the center of a sunflower are flowers. How many of you knew that? Yeah, I looked it up. They're a genus of flower. There's many types other than sunflowers, where there are flowers within flowers. And that's why there's seeds. The seeds are the fruit of those flowers. Huh? Get it? That would make sense. So all of these are thousands of little tiny flowers that get together. And they had a conversation. Hey, let's get together and make one big flower. And they get together, and they make these gorgeous, beautiful flowers. Now look, this one broke off of Trevor's biggest sunflower. Thank you, Trevor.
It's not the biggest.
It wasn't the biggest. It was the biggest one he lugged over today. But it was so heavy that it snapped. But you can see how there are, in fact, little flowers that are just popping. You guys want to look at that? I can leave that with you. For you can look at how, see, those are tiny little flowers that eventually would turn into seeds. And is there a greater image for church than many flowers making one big, beautiful flower? Look at you all. I've been taking photos all morning. Sherry's been taking videos. And don't worry, we'll get you to sign your releases later. So we don't want your agents to come calling. That flower is a bit sticky. I'm just warning you. Smells nice. But we are many, many, many beautiful flowers gathered in this one place to make one beautiful flower for God. But here's what I wanted to remind us of, is that sunflowers are, when I think of them, I think of beauty, and I think of stability, and I think of strength. And I think about that when I think of Mayfair United Church, and when I think of Christ's people here in the world. I think of beauty, and I think of stability, and I think of faithfulness, and I think of strength. But the one thing I want to remind you of is that strength and power are not the same thing. Strength and power are not the same thing. When I see a sunflower, I just think of bold strength. I mean, they just go for it. And they go straight up, and they stand. They just stand so firm and so beautiful and so strong. But it's not the same as power. As a community of faith, here's what I'd like us to take into our fall. I'd like us to think about how we are beautiful flowers, all making one beautiful Mayfair Church flower and one beautiful flower that is the Christian church. But that beauty brings us strength, but it's not to be used as power, that strength. We're not to use it like the church has for so many thousands of years to hurt other people, to judge other people. Just last year, the Pope even finally said to the Catholic Church, let's stop talking about all the things we're against and all the people we don't like. Let's start talking about all the things we're for, all the goodness we're going to share. That's strength, not power. So I was thinking about these beautiful sunflowers and all my sunflower people here at Mayfair. I'd like you to think about all the mission we're going to do this fall, all the gathering we're going to do, all the beauty that we're going to shine for the world. And think of that as being strength for our world, strength that can help and heal and create a home and create a welcome for people, but not power that will hurt people. And then I think we will continue to be beautiful sunflower in this Mayfair neighborhood, in Saskatoon, and for the whole world. May it be so. Amen.